Raising capacity for inclusive people engaged in private sponsorship.
You know that the partners are three organizations from Italy, one local authority and a civil society organization from Greece, and then a center for research and education from Cyprus, and a university institute, and a big NGO from Portugal, and refugees Bienvenue from France.
The refugee sponsorship and mentoring activities that we are going to implement will be managed by these different categories of sponsors and mentors. Hosting families that are families who host one or more refugee or asylum seekers. Supporting families that are families that support asylum seekers or refugees without hosting them. Enterprises mentors, who are figures who get in touch with the refugee during working hours and that can support him or her inside and outside the companies. University students that are young people who become mentors of adolescent, migrant adolescents and young adults. And of course, stakeholders and decision makers, because we are going to create a network on our territories.
The project governance should lie also on local networks for private sponsorships. So groups of associated partners and other relevant stakeholders that are expected to be established very soon in the cities where the partners will develop the training and pilot activities.
To be here and to bring our greetings, just to testimony to testify, sorry, the importance of project, just like Achip, that is a project that unites all the social partners involved in welcoming migrants. Sure that even Achip project will bring a good contribution to a better, how can I say, reception and integration of migrants. So I'm certain that RACIP will be a very, very good project, and it will be, will constitute an example for effective, real reception of immigrants in the territory.
Vi porto i saluti del sindaco Sergio Giollani e di tutta l'amministrazione comunale. E ringrazio il Consorzio Veneto Insieme, capofila del progetto RACIP. Il progetto RACIP è nella direzione di portare appunto la nostra società ad essere comunità. Per questo ringrazio tutti coloro che contribuiscono alla realizzazione e contribuiranno alla realizzazione di questo progetto.
Co-costruire i progetti coinvolgendo tutti i soggetti a partire direttamente dai beneficiari, il rapporto con tutti i soggetti presenti in un territorio a partire dalla pubblica amministrazione, dagli enti locali. Negli ultimi anni abbiamo lavorato insieme assiduamente per andare oltre alla gestione del richiedente asilo o rifugiato, ma agire in un'ottica politica di inclusione sociale. Abbiamo moltissime aspettative rispetto a quello che potrà produrre questo progetto, perché dobbiamo pensare in termini europei e internazionali e poi agire sperimentalmente a livello locale, dove si possono costruire delle buone relazioni.